Sonos with Dad, Renonama Feskema Agus Falcha, Renu Radio Celtic Astràilia-a-Deas, at Coig EBI, Ernioni Tripunk Ern FM, Digitach EBI World, Nyo Sruhug, Erin Lunya. It's Mr. Ernich Nagari, Agus Shaw and Program Sonrichcha, Wa Anzac Agging. Good afternoon and welcome to Celtic Radio Hour here at 5 EBI 103.1 FM or digital at EBI World. My name is Rachel Hay, and a special welcome to anyone listening from further afield with the streaming service at www.5ebi.com.au. Kia mada shavanju, how are you today? This is our Anzac Day special programme, and in the following hour you can expect two things: Anzac Day programming and coronavirus related news. San uri hach bistuhan a chogi fawr aging, agus cwdioch naioch giangolta ry virus a chrwyn, gymi orstynach yn iel môr yn ela sy'n naioch yn drasta. Ach, fe chi mi nach bi yn program sio ro cydrym mar heret. Yes, you're probably sick of coronavirus news, but there really isn't much else in the news at the moment, is there? I've tried to pick the lighter-hearted stories so this program isn't too heavy going. You might also be wondering why you're hearing my voice again so soon. Is that Rachel? Isn't she usually on our airwaves when everyone's on summer holiday? Yes, usually, because I'm usually in Melbourne studying during the year. However, thanks again to coronavirus, university has moved entirely online, and here I am. Shol Misha. Agus shag, gahavastiach haviing erin rejo ach a dachas tauri. Ach, leviras a chrun, chai an kutjolhia agam erin atolin, agus hanig Misha arash ag Australia ajes. Agus leis gyfel cora presenter ela aking yn dram high risk. Bi mi a jain of programmen sy'n y mis yn rychach. Tosio chi mi yn program le pys a fiag frecarach mwyrn biag yn posh cosgel ymol sa ha. So I'll start this program with a piece that would be suitable for the Anzac Day theme, with a tune not so jaunty. This is one of my favourite trad pop bands, the Welsh group Callan, with Pibdowns are for Avorded Frank. You'll have to forgive me, any Welsh speakers listening. The Coast of France, on their album Bling.
when I'm going home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. They pull my hair, they stole my comb, but that's all right till I go home.
She's handsome, she is pretty, she's the belle of Belfast City. She is caught in a 1, 2, 3, please will you tell me who is she?
Mooney says he loves her and all the boys are fighting for her. They're knocking on the door and they're ringing on the bell, saying, oh my true love, are you well?
Out she comes as white as snow, rings on her fingers and bells on her toes. Old Johnny Murphy says she'll die if she doesn't get the fellow with her golden knife. Tell me, ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. Put my hair, let's go, my comb, but that's all right till I go home. She's handsome, she is pretty, she's a belle of Belfast City. She is courting a 1, 2, 3, please have to tell me who is she?
And the snow comes shoveling from the sky.
She's as nice as apple pie, and she'll get her own lad by and by. When she gets a lad of her own, she won't tell her ma when she comes home. Let them all come as they will, as Patrick Murphy she loves still. Tell me ma, when I go home, the boys won't leave the girls alone. Put my hair, stole my comb, and that's alright till I go home. She's handsome, she is pretty, she's the belle of Belfast City. She is courting 1, 2, 3, please will you tell me who is she? She's handsome, she is pretty, she's the belle of Belfast City.
Okay, why did you play that, Rennich? I bet you're asking yourselves. Carson and the Chloechishin. Estrich Nafaklin, listen to the lyrics. I'll tell me ma when I go home. That's where you should all be at the moment, per the new coronavirus restrictions. Unless you're one of the 13 staff at the Isabel Fraser Home, an aged care facility in Inverness, who have decided to stay in campervans on site for the duration of the lockdown. Kirsty Patterson, one of the staff, said that by workers sharing the three campervans on site, they could cut down on the amount of movement to and from the home. "We're giving the residents the comfort and confidence they need," she said. Another person who's entered quite an unusual lockdown life is Chris Lewis, a former paratrooper from Swansea, who has walked 12,000 miles around the UK coastline since August 2017. He was on the Shetland mainland when the lockdown rules came in and was given the keys, or rather the boat, to a hut on the uninhabited island of Hildersay by the local residents. As Jadu Chris Lewis Korshach for Abertawe, Shias and Imulfariga Rioch Gernicha, Va Mohir Shalting, and Nur Hanig Nurilchen lockdown as Jach, Marshin, Legluch Naskira, Kid a Via Fuddach Nelan Hildersay, Colory Shaku, agus corach cyrrych. Ha bat a ti yn gytrych le bwrn agus gôl agus ha maestio Lewis ag iasgach agus a sialagorach gus biag aing. Hwrst eich gofil eich ho sôn as fai rhyf. Since arriving on Hildersay, Mr. Lewis had survived through collecting driftwood, foraging, fishing, and a regular boat bringing fresh water and coal. "It's really given me a chance to enjoy the island," he said. "I'm the happiest I've ever been." Life in isolation isn't wonderful for everyone, though. Ha fiawn awnum pandi balavech gawn yn Cymru y graag gyfeli at y farych gan ywegnioch, leis gyfel yn cwtiet y linach a chomalia. Gyhofysdiach ha fi ach Lewis yn embiach ga agos I et yn gwn signal ffon live. Residents of Pandy, a village in the Ceiriog Valley in Wales, say they feel cut off during lockdown thanks to their internet speeds of 1 MB or less, and limited mobile phone signal. I can understand being frustrated by slow internet speeds. Alison Bendel, a resident of Pandy, works as a school counsellor for the Denbighshire Council and says it's difficult to communicate with vulnerable children and young people during this time. va a vi gan fiking as agus eitsen nam hiking hin gus an big kyangal at a lean ma agin gus anurin gain tech a horse gaif horse dia gus kudjuch gura visek dunya gura shin an rowing ach a hain a vi a fulda her an duich ach gundane get a lean nas loya do choas nach gan ellis an thra. It would be lovely to be able to see my students and for them to see me, Alison Bendel said, and to have a good internet connection so that we can offer the support they need. People in the area know it's their choice to live in a rural location, but other parts of the valley have been connected to faster fibre broadband speeds. And speaking of online schools, and as a former School of the Air pupil myself, online schooling seems a bit of a no-brainer at this time, especially in a country which has been doing it for 70 years. It's great to see that state broadcasters in many countries have increased their weekday educational programming. Amigbalach agus kalika jen of naskola eran etalina nish agus hakrela deren anonimic duach er in kuch program fall amach aveadachig. Ach, jema yen the clown ekavil parentan ek nachel and canon elns of elen kuch obrach skola achke. What about children who have schoolwork in a language their parents don't speak? Well, Wales has the answer to that. Until a few weeks ago, 63% of children in Welsh medium education had non-Welsh speaking parents. Well, this is still the case. But until a few weeks ago, those parents had assumed that their children would spend 30 hours a week immersed in the language. Now, on top of the general concern which all the parents are feeling about keeping up education during coronavirus, such parents are worried that their children's language skills will also suffer and they will be behind in just the spoken language of the school by the time they go back. Ha emig dunya a cruich cael ŵr er yn leinio gus cwdych ag a hwrt er cleinio fma sin, stwch yn sborsol agus stwch yn chegysg. Many Welsh-speaking parents, teachers and community members have started creating new online content, both fun content and, educational to help such children. Mike Gwyneth, a musician from Cardiff, has started YouTube ukulele lessons in Welsh every Tuesday and Thursday morning, while cartoonist Hugh Aaron has been making daily videos to help kids get creative. Mae'r hels dy hyn sborsol un sy'n a'r hael nyr yn etal un awns o'ch ymrys, hwrs dy awns o'ch ymrys ein, ystoch yn a clenio clawn a chan yn ffat miasyn, he said. Or rather, if there's no fun, interest and content for kids in Welsh, they might not hear the language much at all for months. Pam Mariana Nick Ulrich, Shenada Voglasahu, a Jane of Datmarshin Kudjach, yet the Hangahi, and Yeoman Avuachich, Agasan Press Erdich, Agasanish, Haig Levig, Da Hurris, Gachshachking. Marianne Kennedy, a singer from Glasgow, is doing a similar thing. She has translated The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe into Gaelic, and is now reading it twice a week live on Facebook. You can still tune in and listen by searching for the Facebook page. And Yawan of Uchech Agus and Press Erdach. Sitting got Jess Jachas, Jerich Lorig and Dunyog Facebook Achke. And the videos are still up there to listen. There have been two chapters so far. Well, The Lion, the Witch and the Wardrobe brings us very tidily towards our other theme of the day, because after all, the book takes place during the Second World War. So I'll tie that in with the earlier story about a man who has spent the last 3 years wandering around the coast of the UK to bring you a word from our programme sponsor, Eric Bogle. Here he is with And the Band Played Waltzing Matilda.
Now when I was a young man, I carried me pack, and I lived the free life on the rover. From the Murray's green basin to the dusty outback, well, I waltzed my Matilda all over. Then in 1915, my country said, son, it's time you stop rambling, there's work to be done. So they gave me a tin hat and they gave me a gun, and they marched me away to the war. And the band played Waltzing Matilda as the ship pulled away from the quay. And amidst all the cheers, the flag waving and tears, we sailed off for Gallipoli. And how well I remember that terrible day, how our blood stained the sand and the water, and of how in that hell that they called Suvla Bay, we were butchered like lambs at the slaughter. Johnny Turkey was waiting, he'd primed himself well. He showered us with bullets and he rained us with shell. And in 5 minutes flat, he'd blown us all to hell. Nearly blew us right back to Australia. But the band played Waltzing Matilda. When we stopped to bury our slain, we buried ours and the Turks buried theirs. Then we started all over again. And those that were left, well, we tried to survive in that mad world of blood, death and fire. And for 10 weary weeks I kept myself alive, though around me the corpses piled higher. Then a big Turkish shell knocked me arse overhead, and when I woke up in me hospital bed and saw what it had done, well, I wished I was dead. Never knew there was worse things than dying, for I'll go no more waltzing Matilda. All around the green bush far and free, to hum tents and pegs, a man needs both legs. No more waltzing Matilda for me. So they gathered the crippled, the wounded, the maimed, and they shipped us back home to Australia. The legless, the armless, the blind, the insane, those proud wounded heroes of Suvla. And as our ship pulled into Circular Quay, I looked at the place where me legs used to be, and thank Christ there was nobody waiting for me. To grieve, to mourn and to pity, but the band played Waltzing Matilda as they carried us down the gangway. But nobody cheered, they just stood and stared. Then they turned all their faces away. And so now, every April, I sit on me porch and I watch the parade pass before me. And I see my old comrades, how proudly they march, reviving old dreams of past glories. And the old men march slowly, all bones stiff and sore. They're tired old heroes from a forgotten war. And the young people ask, what are they marching for? And I ask myself the same question. But the band plays Waltzing Matilda, and the old men still answer the call. But as year follows year, more old men disappear. Someday no one will march there at all. Waltzing Matilda, Waltzing Matilda, oh, come a waltzing Matilda with me. And their ghosts may be heard as they march by that boulevard. Oh, come a waltzing Matilda with me.
And now every April I sit on my porch. Well, perhaps you did today, but I doubt you saw a parade pass before you. Perhaps you got up in time for a dawn service at the end of your driveway. I know many did, and stood with a candle to play the last post. Now, I don't know that there's much that I can say about Anzac Day, especially as the time to enact all the how to observe Anzac Day during lockdown advice that was circulated in the media has been and gone. But I'm not sure how many people are listening from overseas, so I might give a quick explanation of what Anzac Day is. Mashin, Jay Halman wa Anzac. Hala Anzac na ser la nashanta alin Australia agus alin shalog noe. Aha a kynyachig a kogag vod. A karsan nach beg la a kynyachig aking, a starving, ma a hectuchan an ella. Well, be la a kynyachig aking an ur shin gajerev. Ach sin kogag mor, hacha bla aun an turk. Aha buag vod a horste Australia agus shalog noe. Ha Anzac na gyar anam. An archer, Australian New Zealand Army Corps. Tras of acting as Ritlin, Naked Jake Sakayuk Jake, Rick Nahanzak said Troy Alnantuch, Erevel Gallipoli. Erskas Gundurit and Orstu Shin, Assassin. Achva and Tarum Turkach a Fehavrish, Agus Haikuchas Moy and Anzacs of Van Varavag, and La Shin. Marshingach Giplin. Sin cog of la fichet, sin coig of la fichet, gav malesh gul be la anzac agging. Bishin a dolg and terrava, she classig and la, farin clinic shin and last post. Agus ihi shin aran corca. Brini minas mo aran corca, kion vinich. Dawn service may have been a solitary affair this morning, but you know something else that can work well on your own? Anzac biscuits. My mother made some yesterday. And yes, I am going to relate Anzac biscuits to something Celtic, because have you ever noticed how similar Anzac biscuits are to Aran Corca oatcakes? I did a little bit of research this week and found out some very interesting things. No one can seem to agree on where the recipe came from, but the earliest instance of the Anzac name being attached to it comes... attached to the recipe that we know today, comes from New Zealand in 1921, and prior to that, it had been used for a variety of other cakes and biscuits, but usually that was because writers of recipe books renamed them in books that were published during the war in order to promote patriotic sentiment. An interesting thing is coconut wasn't actually added to the Anzac biscuit recipe until 6 years after it first appearing with that name in a cookbook in 1927. And then some people began to use wheat instead of oats during the 40s and 50s. And by the 60s, recipe books sort of stopped labelling anything Anzac at all. And apparently it wasn't until the 80s and 90s that food writers started promoting Anzac biscuits again. Not always with the same name, one chocolate-coated form was promoted as the Millennium Biscuit instead of the Anzac Biscuit. So some people contest the idea that Anzac biscuits and Aran Corca are at all related, because they say there's not much similarity apart from the fact that they both have oats in them. Such people are probably also likely to claim that haggis and Christmas pudding have no relation to each other, but historical cookbooks tell us otherwise. Recipes change over time, prompted by environment and needs and the ingredients available. Aran Corca oatcakes are traditionally savoury and used like a slice of bread, but recipes from the 1890s show that sugar and syrup had started to be added sometimes, and that was a couple of decades before the First World War. So when women left at home in Australia and New Zealand needed something relatively non-perishable to send to soldiers overseas, why wouldn't they have adapted a very familiar recipe, Aran Corca, oatcakes, but without eggs, using the far less perishable golden syrup as a binding agent instead of the eggs? That makes it sweeter. And with how persistent the basic recipe has then been over the last century, going through coconut, chocolate, nuts and all sorts of other phases of things being added and taken out to reflect various current tastes and needs, it seems reasonable to me to think that it's a recipe that's been with us a lot longer than just the last century. So I put it to you that an Anzac biscuit recipe, without the coconut, which was added in the 1920s, and with the maple syrup swapped back for eggs as a binder, begins to look very much like an oatcake recipe. And after all, if people needed a staple food to send to their sons and brothers overseas, why not rely on something that's already a staple food? Well, that's enough of me rambling on. We're nearly halfway through the programme, so it might be time for some notices. First, a Welsh notice. We have so few of those. One Adelaide resident, Jamie Webster, is coordinating an online Nos on Lawan, something like a ceilidh, on behalf of the Welsh Dragon Choir in Portland in the US. It will be held on May the 23rd, and international participants, that's us in Australia, are welcome. You can find out more information at www.portlandwelsh.org. That's www.portlandwelsh.org. Next, Aveluerton Gaelic Ionsachig. Have you been sitting, listening to me waffling away in Gaelic, wishing you could understand me? Well, now you can. Comunn Rèidio Astràilia is offering online classes aimed at advanced beginners. That is, people with a little bit of Gaelic knowledge, such as Duolingo, which began last Tuesday. If you fit that demographic, you can still join though. The classes are $10 a week, or $80 for 10 weeks, and available to all members of Comunn Rèidio Astràilia. Membership is another $30. For more information, email FIOS, that's F-I-O-S, email FIOS at ozgaelic.com. That's O-Z-Gaelic.com. FIOS at ozgaelic.com. I'm sorry, ozgaelic.org, not .com. Now, they're the only two Celtic community notices I have for this week. If you're listening and you're a member of one of Australia's Celtic communities and you have a notice that you'd like to see advertised here on Celtic Radio Hour, please get in touch with me or Margot. My email is Rachel, that's R-A-C-H-E-L, dot Hay, that's H-A-Y, the same as Jim, at iinet.net.au. And I'll include your notice in my next programme on the 9th of May. In the meantime, here's Eric Bogle again. This time singing a song that I was surprised to learn is called No Man's Land. You may know it better, as I do, as Willie McBride.
Well, how to do Private William McBride? Do you mind if I sit here down by your grey side? And I'll rest for a while in the warm summer sun. I've been walking all day, Lord, and I'm nearly done. I see by your gravestone you were only 19 when you joined the glorious fallen in 1916. Well, I hope you died quick and I hope you died clean. Or Willie McBride, was it slow and obscene? Did they beat the drum slowly? Did they sound the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ye as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flutes of the forest? And did you leave a wife for a sweetheart behind? In some faithful heart is your memory enshrined? And though you died back in 1916, to that loyal heart are you always 19? Or are you a stranger without even a name, forever enshrined behind some glass pane in an old phone?
done and tattered and stained, and fading to yellow in a brown leather frame. Did they beat the drums slowly? Did they sound the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ye as they lowered you down? Did the bugles sing last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flutes of the forest? The sun shining now on these green fields of France. The warm wind blows gently and the red poppies dance. The trenches have vanished long under the plough. No gas and no barbed wire, no guns firing now. But here in this graveyard, it's still no man's land. The countless white crosses in mute witness stand to man's blind indifference to his fellow man, and a whole generation who were butchered and damned. Did they beat the drums slowly? Did they sound the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ye as they lower ye down? Did the bugles sing last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flutes of the forest? And I can't help but wonder now, Willie McBride, do all those who lie here know why they died? Did you really believe them when they told you the cause? You really believe that this war would end war? The suffering, the sorrow, the glory, the shame, the killing, the dying, it was all done in vain. For Willie McBride, it all happened again, and again, and again, and again, and again. Did they beat the drums slowly? Did they sound the fife lowly? Did the rifles fire o'er ye as they lowered ye down? Did the bugles sing the last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flutes of the forest? Did the bugles sing the last post in chorus? Did the pipes play the flutes of the forest?
Hall she forgets Jochri Ure Jochelchuk Australia AJS Coig EBI Ernioni 3.9 FM or Digital EBI World News Ruig and online. You're listening to Celtic Radio Hour on 5 EBI 103.1 FM, on digital EBI World, or now streaming online. I'm program shower, so now you have all the Cymru, Eire, agus fun pobl cilteach a seo, an in Australia, a jes agus a hula dwych, agus a hula tŵl. So, this program is for those interested in things Scottish, Welsh, Irish, Cornish, Breton and Manx, as well as news from the Celtic communities here in South Australia and nationwide. Nambeag tolef bol radio avias, chanyl a Jack Dolog ach blian agus beag sif ga cwdioch ag gajeraf. Cyr y ffong gw maerit ec nion I cech yn 3 siach gael coig 3 siach. If you'd like to help us stay on air, you can become a member for only $10 a year. To find out more or to get an application form, please ring Margot on 0413 722 537. That's 0413 722 537. Che sorsa naiach, you might be asking. What sort of news? Well, in rofisach at nach dur and tervish chasagan nam bion garum vachiln and darnla fichet avasht. Scottish Mountain Rescue says its teams haven't been called out since the 22nd of March, making it the longest time between calls since the foot and mouth outbreak of 2001, which restricted access, land access for months. Meanwhile, the Fire and Rescue Service in Northern Ireland has been extremely busy, dealing with 300 gorse fires in the last 3 weeks. Agus hoistic gan jack cutra smoi and three kiad falish gan shin glas ledirnia. Most of those fires, they say, were started deliberately. Well, she is thralia nach a hunamsa, ma shin ha biach anaka muna shen ga keenchach. I'm Australian, so I definitely have thoughts about people who light bushfires. But I'm pleased to report that not everyone has been a social menace during this epidemic. In Scotland, fishermen who no longer have access to their European markets have been cultivating a distribution chain in the local community, which they hope will continue after coronavirus. Ha easkaran alan alapa ru rutan tionskala hayenev gus easkareik. Ma shin ha bieg namar ru reichinish sin kowashnach inadil. Eren linea agus jirach gud dorsan na luch kialnachi. Agus ha easkaran an dochas gumar sha as jivirus achrun. Ha sha eravi erhle skanyal hush fair. Ha han marag margach yorpach kudjachal. Agus na hauman an sha, chan nurengu chivi an nurach grish. One fisherman said, it's been absolutely fantastic. We realised that European market was a useful asset, but at times like this, it's nothing you can count on. Bally Phillip, who fishes out of Kyleakin, says, I've been doing local sales every Thursday, and several other boats have been doing sales on alternate days. Although there's not a huge market here within the local community, we're getting a lot of support. Chaniel market uavasach mór a cha, ach sin cowas nach ianadil ha sin a fain mór an teich, ha sin a nachas gan biag seo dacht a maring agus a mead a chug. We're hoping that this might be something that continues and something that develops over time. Funeral directors, of all people, are also hoping that coronavirus will build community spirit, or at least bring back an old tradition they think has been lost. Ha luchtori an an alapa a giri dogeunia siaun chlachga gahoos de rash, leis na rielchen astarach ag sosialta a haging. Sna siaun lion haiat de gra, biag dernia a shasav a fehav agas a jain of bech, nur a vis gulon a dol shachat. Haiat an biach gun yo ag sio curam dogeunia urum a hoos dogeunia a kirklugs na lean shaw, nur nach bikedach a golgan service chil chug hain. Some funeral directors in Scotland would like to bring back the tradition of people standing, waiting, and bowing as a hearse passes them in the streets. It rarely happens these days, they pointed out. But as one funeral director said, at this time when many people can't attend a funeral, it would be nice to see this tradition come back as a sign of marking that person's life, and for everyone to show support of the bereaved during this time. From death to birth, and one proud parent is Tim Fuge in Cornwall, who spent the last week making and eating a pasty the size of his newborn son. The beef pasty was nearly 3 kilos in weight and half a metre in diameter, the same weight and length as two-week-old Joan. Tim said the trickiest part was finding a baking tray big enough. Well, we're getting towards the end of our hour, but it might just be time for some animal news. This week in animal news, three rescued kittens, less than a week old, found near Redruth, the one in Cornwall, not the one here in South Australia, have been named after historical NHS figures. They're being hand-reared and are doing well. Elsewhere in Cornwall, it's more animal fears than animal news, as residents in the seaside town of Loo, with an E on the end, are concerned that they will be swarmed by seagulls. They have reason for that fear, thanks to the lockdown. The usual seagull control measures have been cancelled. Martin Gregory, the mayor, said the lockdown should mean that seagulls are back to their normal feeding grounds and away from the streets because easy pickings had dried up with people staying away from coastal towns and villages. But seagull expert Madeline Gormas from the University of Exeter thinks otherwise. They're still getting a lot of food, potentially from rubbish bins, she said. I'd be very surprised if they change their behaviour. From Seagulls to Swans then, and here's Donnie McLeod singing An Yalla Van. Chai An Yalla Van Ascrivig le Don Ruig Haruna Machoil, Clachet agus Barsha Hanamal a Yuish Tatua, Nurivaya Saba Chans and Rang, Sir Kogog Vod. Hai Scrivcha Ma Orangil do Maggie Nick Lodge, Avan Brahmara Ekanaum. And Yalla Van, The White Swan, was written by Red Donald MacDonald, a stonemason from North Uist and famous Gaelic war poet during the Battle of the Somme, and is addressed to Maggie MacLeod, who was his sweetheart at the time. Marshin Shaw A and Yalla Van.
Fonen uaregak mi piaunten artich jo, Gleaunten ne van rangnen lochnen bagsnen strom, Senjale van atavoru, Gach lawer fel mi'n tor. Y fagin na bitwr soch yr wyn get yw un bas. Co yn fer ymysg yn lwy y farys bwyn gybrach. Chaniel sinyl ach cwrst mae'r i han bwyl y ffas. Des si ond yn y blion y sias, snach tog y grian yn arst. Ham I sy'n sios mohul sy'n ier o'n chrom y grian sy'n tal. Mogur o'ch glec me a se cheik e treig I mi chotra. Gynnys gym ffeic mi mar o'ch unwyr ieris I gwharst. Is I ymwyrs lawn gyfyr eich eill, nwyrs lir gyn byl yn law. Han talu ler man kwrst ym na fi alan sues na nyol. Ek ne shels y bwyl chal ler gofu ym lecio. Gyn chlasht nioch gag moch lwys yn le ffwai mewn y fwrd. Ach get an nwys o crwai aram am os mwyn jen ni cloed. Mwylin iawns ne traes eich yn ham un jyn o'r stegrau. Nam chato be me brwyd yr o'r stchato loch o fislan. Hamaic nawr y lion y glecion ol y scholan. Segrw y gylas gorw y gorym en I sier hwyr fi ban. Mas es gyfel en dan o on vlar gynchil mi bio. Esque feic minta che sen jachi marohok Pishinis karahe glava kenis pilen platosht fok Smyjauten is bepaeshtje gud Le fanje gud meid vjord
Shanyo warina wakatun kam Ui viik na frank Ui shikas ta sikas ropu na mikke Spaka helam di Ui mahatari kas ka shanyo wari kas
there singing Bachachilandi, a song which, the CD cover tells me, is about the Battle of Killala, which was fought on the 23rd of September 1796. The Irish side had a number of French fighters, and it's thought that the Hilandi, which looks like Descendants of Andy in Irish, bit of the song title is actually the French word Irlandais, meaning Irish. It's been a bit of a depressing time overall recently, but sticking with the important battles in Gaelic history theme, you might recall another which had an anniversary last Thursday. That is, of course, Bla Culloden, the Battle of Culloden, which took place on the 16th of April 1746. Hánaigh Mac Gael had a mara as Jé Bla Culloden, a hachar an seachin seo a chéan dach gheat bléin a ceirt jig ar trí fichat, agus hánaigh Emma Gael ag Astràilia go cínseach. Sin an uver a bhíos Gael ástail na seo san Latin Jew a brian ar an radio. After the Battle of Culloden, many Gaels were forced off the land, and ultimately that sent many of them across the sea to Australia, New Zealand, Canada and America. So we'll finish with Duich Mackay, sung by Fiona McKenzie, because we're running short of time, and that's Sinné, really, an avua manish vun u radio kelchach, Astràilia-a-Deas, eg coeg EBI in 93.1 FM. That's pretty much all we have time for today on Celtic Radio Hour at 5EBI 103.1 FM. So it's goodbye from me, Rachel Hay. Cheerion drasta agus eich avalev. He shan chef an ahiachging Celtic Radio Hour. We'll be back at the same time next week with Des. And don't forget, Scottish Radio Hour at 12:30 PM on Tuesday, and Irish Radio just after it at 1:30. Bi o re jo cael chacharesh ac yn yna o'n a'ch iachgyng, ac bi o re jo alopanach a'n cwdiach gael lech o'r ysdeimi yn lwad i marsht, ac o re jo erinach dyrach ysdei sy'n ac le o'r ysdei o'r. Bi mis y hen yr a'ch ac iawn cola jeg. I myself will be back in a fortnight. Until then, here's Fiona McKenzie with Dwy Fichai, a song about the clearances, on her CD Jo Yesh Erdych, A Good Suit of Clothes, Songs of the Immigrant Gael.
Mestrat du ich gei na fasa.